Its art galleries, which are not moving, attract people from all over the world. Although Haitian artists paint in every style, from abstract to primitive, the naive style depicting the everyday life of the Haitian people is what has made Haitian painting famous. Haiti's second largest city, Cap-Haïtien, is 10 times smaller than the capital. Artists, artisans, and street vendors of all kinds perform their labor right on the sidewalk. Life outside of the bustling capital is visibly lived in a very different way. The center of Cap-Haïtien is still exactly the way it was nearly 200 years ago. Cap Français, as it was called during those times, was then the capital of the country. Its buildings were made in a very particular colonial style. The iron balconies with their elaborate ornamentation are typical of 18th century French and Spanish architecture. The cathedral, with its impressive dome, sits in the principal square of the city. Most of the battles for independence were fought in and around the city walls. When it fell to the slave army, independence was won. It was also the capital of King Henri Christophe, who built the Sanssouci Palace as his main residence. Even though it exists today as a ruin, its former splendor lives on. High above the palace, on a solitary peak, he built the citadel, a fortress designed to repel the expected French invasion, which never arrived. Dream of grandeur, lost in the clouds. Sitting at the bottom of a bay lies the town of Jacmel, famous for its poets and its unique style of colonial architecture. Many of the buildings were constructed by Haitians who studied in Paris in the mid-19th century. Upon returning from abroad, they brought back the designs and ironwork needed to replicate these styles. Once a bustling town involved in trade of coffee, sugar, and indigo, Jacmel today exists with a charm of these past shadows while it proceeds in the direction of a more artistically focused community. Painting shops exist all over town. Most artists work with their doors open so that those passing by can see their work in progress. Some focus purely on landscapes and scenery, while others paint in a more decorative fashion. producing souvenirs and utensils. The carnival masks are another of the area's specialties. Some represent well-known characters of the Haitian folklore, and others despised politicians or military leaders. When two or three of these characters meet during carnival time, a skit can be improvised on the spot, and the street becomes a stage. But the tropical sun can make it very uncomfortable to carry out a tradition. So the mask is lifted for a breath of fresh air.